ओके हेलो क्लास 5, टुडे विल स्टार्ट द नाइन्थ चैप्टर ऑफ सोशल स्टडीज, दैट इज वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट. सो द मेन थीम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज द अर्थ एंड इज जियोग्राफिकल फीचर्स. नाउ द थ्री थिंग्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस चैप्टर एंड दैट इज वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट, राइट. सेकेंड इज द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग द क्लाइमेट एंड थर्ड इज क्लाइमेटिक चेंजेस इन द present. So the first thing that we are going to study is about weather. Now weather, what happens in weather? Weather changes in a minute, in a seconds, or the very next moment. Like suddenly you'll have a pleasant weather, you'll feel the pleasant weather, and then all of a sudden you'll feel little warmer. So weather keeps on changing, weather never stays at stable, it keeps on changing. Okay, so this is what weather is, fine. So we'll see what it says more about weather. Often you hear people say that the weather is pleasant, but the very next moment stormy winds start blowing. Now at one moment we say that weather is very pleasant, but the next moment what happens? The stormy wind starts to blow. Weather is what happens in the atmosphere every day. Now weather is something which happens in the atmosphere every day. There is always a change in weather. Okay, sometimes you'll feel cold, sometimes you'll feel warmer, sometimes you'll feel little, the winds will blow, right? So weather keeps on changing. In a day, it can change in many times. Now, the day-to-day condition of the atmosphere is called weather. Now, the day-to-day condition of the atmosphere, the changes in atmosphere in a regular basis, on a regular days, is known as weather. It can change many times in a day. Like I said, in a day it can change many times. Weather conditions may also vary in a small area, such that it may be raining in one part of the city and another part might have a sunny day at the same time. Now often we must have seen that in some part of the area you'll find that in one area it rains heavily, while when you come to the other area you'll find the place is dry. So this is what changes happens in weather, right? Now despite being susceptible to sudden changes, weather can be predicted. These predictions are made by the weather stations. These weather stations have different instruments which are used to record data about the weather conditions, such as the temperature, humidity, etc. Sometimes the weather remains more or less the same for longer periods of time, usually the same part of the year. We call these periods seasons. There are 5 different seasons: summer, monsoon, autumn, winter, and spring. However, not all places on earth experience monsoon. Now, what happens in weather? Weather can be predicted. That means it can be forecasted. And why there's a need of forecast for weather? So that if any mishap will take place, any hazardous things will take place, in order to save people from any hazardous thing, the weather forecast is being done. Now where do weather forecast is done? There are various weather stations, and what happens in these weather stations, different instruments are used. Okay, they keep the data, they record the data about the weather condition with the help of different instruments which are present in weather station. And what do they forecast? What do they predict? They predict about the weather, like what kind of a weather it's going to be in future. And why it happens, why it is predicted? So that anything, if anything will happen, like if any flood will come, it will aware people about those floods, so that before time people can reach to the safest place. And what other things that this weather stations keep record of, or what other things they forecast about? They forecast about the temperature, whether the temperature will be low, whether the temperature will be high, whether the weather will be humidity, whether it will be warmer, whether it will be a little bit cool, whether it will rain, and if it's going to rain, then for how many days it will rain, whether it will be only a thunderstorm. So this is what all happens in weather stations. Right now, sometimes the weather remains more or less the same for the longer periods. Like sometimes what happens, weather stays for longer period of time. Right, we call these periods seasons, and we call them the weather which remains for longer period of time. We call it weather. We call it periods, seasons. And how many seasons are there? There are 5 different seasons. Summer holidays. You get summer holidays for 1 month. No, then monsoon, then autumn, then winter. Again, for winter you get 1 month's holiday, and spring. But here what happens, not every places on earth experiences monsoon. Very few places on earth that experiences monsoon. Okay, now weather is understood. Now we'll move forward to climate. What happens in climate? See, climate is a long-term pattern of weather in a particular place. Now climate, it is a long-term pattern of weather in a... Now what happens in climate? Climate takes years, decades, hundreds, or even thousands of years to change. See, however, climate does not change so suddenly. Climate doesn't change suddenly. It takes longer period of time. Thousands of years it takes to change. For any change to occur in the climate of a place, this is the main difference between weather and climate. Now, this is the main difference between weather and climate. Weather changes every day, every minute, and every hour, but climate doesn't changes so easily. Now different parts of the world have different climates. Now different parts of the world, they have different climates. In some regions it is cold and freezing, and in others it is hot and dry. Now there are places in the world that experience cold and freezing throughout the year, and there are certain places like which experiences hot and dry season. If it is hot and dry throughout the year, it is hot and dry. If it is cold and freezing throughout the year, it is cold and freezing. Okay, now the variety of life that exists on earth is because of these climatic differences. The same pattern is noticed in animals as well. Now we adjust ourselves according to the weather, according to the climate. We being the human being, we adjust ourselves the way the climate is, the way the weather is. This is what happens with animals too. Even they adapt themselves according to the climate, according to the weather. Okay, now, animals such as polar bears and penguins, which are inhabitants of the polar regions, will not be able to survive in the equatorial regions. Now polar bears and penguins, if you have seen them, they usually stay in cold and freezing area. They cannot live in hot and dry place. They won't be able to survive. They will definitely die if they'll come out of their cold and freezing, from their cold and freezing area, because they have adapted themselves. They have become an inhabitant, means the cold and freezing area has become their permanent place to live. And they are very well surviving over there. And if you pick them up and if you bring them in a hot and dry season, in hot and dry weather, they will die. Now, what do you understand by polar regions? Polar regions mean frigid zone, mostly covered with ice, like mountains and everything. The rivers is usually cold and it is all covered with ice. And the temperature is usually at 0 degrees. Okay, now next, Climate also influences the development of cultures and civilizations. People adapt themselves to the climate of the place they live in. Now, like I said, people, we, the human being, we adapt ourselves according to the weather, according to the climate. So does the animals. So, the kind of food we eat, clothes we wear, houses we live in are all determined by the climate. Now, wherever we live, whatever we eat, it is all determined by the climate. We adapt ourselves according to the climate. For example, people living in hot desert regions do not wear coats. For example, if someone who is living in hot desert, do you think that they are going to wear winter clothes? Do you think that they'll wear woolen clothes? No, they're definitely not going to wear woolen clothes. Right. Similarly, if any person goes to stay in a cold area, will he be without woolen clothes? Will he be able to survive without woolen clothes? No. So according to the climate, we have to keep ourselves. If we live in hot and dry area, we have to live without woolen clothes. We have to wear more of cotton clothes. But if we choose to live in cold and freezing areas, then we have to carry our woolen clothes with us. According to the climate, we have to live. Right. Now, then, in India, which is an agriculture country, farmers grow different kinds of crop. Now, India, which is considered as an agriculture country. Why it is considered as an agriculture country? Because over here, the farmers, they grow different variety of crops and even fruits, vegetables, we get according to the climate. We don't get to eat all the vegetables, all the fruits every year, but according to the climate, the farmers, they grow different kinds of fruits and vegetables. This variety is possible only because of the variation in the climate of the country. Now, the variety of fruits and vegetables is only possible, it is because of the climate. Okay, now we'll discuss the difference between weather and climate. Weather is the atmospheric condition, whereas that prevails for a short period of time. That means whatever happens in atmosphere, it happens for a short period of time. But what happens in climate? Climate is the atmospheric condition, okay, of a place that remains for longer period of time. Weather is susceptible to sudden changes. Now, weather can be forecasted. Just by looking outside, even you can forecast that if you see the clouds, you can forecast that it's going to rain. The weather is cloudy. But what happens in climate? It may change, but it takes a longer period of time to change. Okay, weather affects the daily life of people. Now, weather, it affects daily life of people. Now, climate has long-term effects. Now, climate, it has a long-time effects. Why long-time effects? Because it takes time to change. And it affects on what? It affects on food habits, transportation, housing, occupation, and lifestyle of people. It also influences the vegetation and wildlife of a place. Okay, so this is the difference between weather and climate. So far you have understood the difference between weather and climate, and like I said in your live classes that you have to do this homework. You'll be doing it, you'll observe your place where you live, and accordingly you will write the weather in the morning, weather in the afternoon, and weather in the evening, and you have to complete this box. Okay, so today we'll complete till here. In the next part of the video, we'll begin with the factors affecting climate. Okay, till then, take care.